So today we're going to demonstrate a quick technique on using AK Interactive Rust, Crusted Rust deposits, as you can see right here. And then we'll use mineral spirits to clean it up, but you could also use AK Interactive's white spirits. Mineral spirits work perfectly fine for cleaning the brush afterwards, so you could save your money on the AK Interactive stuff. Not saying anything. So the AK Interactive, you take straight from the bottle, dip your brush in, and simply brush it on. The car roof that I'm doing, the whole roof is covered in rust, except for some very small patches that are showing silver. And then the railroad went back and filled some of the seams with the epoxy that they use to keep it from leaking into the car. That can all be done after the fact. Right now we're just going with AK Interactive for a base coat. For this technique, we're just using the AK Interactive to get a base rust. To clean the brush, simply dip it in the mineral spirits and brush it off. I took a picture of the prototype at West Colton.
Oh, wow.
Pepper Avenue.
How
recent? 2015. So after we added the AK Interactive Crusted Rust to the roof, you can see how uneven the rust went on. I will take the iron oxide extra dark PanPastel and put it on fairly heavy, covering almost all of the AK Interactive. But the AK Interactive, because it went on so uneven, will hold the paint or the PanPastel in different tones. You get lights and darks depending on how much AK Interactive was in an area and how well the PanPastel sticks to it. You don't want it to be even, so this actually works out perfectly in our favor. This boxcar roof had an almost completely covered rusty roof with a few small shaded silver spots, which I'll add back in later with a brush. But as you can see, it's not an even coverage. Now I'll take just a little bit of the iron oxide red and kind of dab it in here. With the red iron oxide added. So as you saw in the previous segment, we used AK Interactive for our base coat for PanPastel chalks. Now this car looks fine as is. It has been clear coated, so you can see some small white patches where the AK Interactive was lighter in the car. If you want, you can stop right here. Because our prototype has a much darker rust down the middle of the car, we're going to continue in with much darker PanPastels. This dark bluish gray and a burnt sienna color. Starting with the burnt sienna, we're going to go along the edges, just dabbing it in. You'll see I get some brush motion and some dabbing motion going. This helps to make sure that the PanPastel actually grinds into the clear coat that we used. Now you can see the burnt sienna color. Down the center, we're going to add some more of this dark bluish gray right here. We want to be light on this one
Now just a little bit of black, just to kind of darken it a little bit deeper. I'm not quite satisfied with the color that's on there yet, so I want it a little bit darker. That's why I'm going with the black. Now that we have clear coated the model again, you can see that we have a much darker roof, more appropriate to the prototype shown earlier in the video. I've gone ahead and marked a couple of seams with white gel pen so that I can tell which seams I need to cover with this craft paint. It is granite gray from Apple Barrel Colors. It's available at Walmart for about 50 cents. This color will replicate the epoxy coating that they put on these seams to keep them from leaking. So we'll take a small, fine-tipped brush, simply dip it in the paint, paint straight across the seam. No need to be really perfect with this, because the painters that do it are using a very large brush or a roller of some sort when they put it on. It's not always even. But try to keep it just on the seam, not covering half the roof, unless that's the car, what the car looks like that you're picking. This one had only a few of its seams patched. This is a matte paint, so it should dry fairly quickly. About the time the video is done recording, it should be dry for me. As you can see, the white mark, that was to delineate which one I needed to paint. And here's a completed rib. And here we have the completed roof with AK Interactive Base, PanPastel Rust, and Apple Barrel Colors for the epoxy seam coating. As you can see, I went back and dry brushed some Mission models silver on it. This will be covered in a future episode, but this replicates the areas of the car that were not rusted. This is my completed boxcar roof for this car.
Here. So, just buy a pack of steel BBs from Walmart. And it's like 200 of them in, for like $5, and then just drop one in each one, because you need something to. Because there's a lot of like crust and all that in the bottom, so you need something to really shake it up. And then I'm just using a cheap wider brush. This thing, all you can actually see how it's still left some in the brush. So I pretty much only use this brush for this. I don't use any of the other ones. Unless I'm doing a small spot, then I'll use a smaller brush. Pat it on, don't brush it, because you're going to rub off the AK Interactive if you brush it too much. You just want to kind of dab it on there. But you'll see how it doesn't stick evenly. It kind of does lights and darks. That's exactly what you're looking for, is the lights and darks.